Next, I will teach you block diagrams and signal flow graphs. First topic is transfer function. Transfer function of a linear time invariant system is defined as Laplace transform of the output divided by Laplace transform of the input under the assumption all initial conditions are zero. I again repeat, transfer function of a linear time invariant system is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of the output to Laplace transform of the input under the assumption all initial conditions are zero. Transfer function is applicable only for linear time invariant systems. I'll write the transfer function of a linear time invariant system is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of the output to Laplace transform of the input under the assumption all initial conditions are zero. Under the assumption all initial conditions are zero. The concept of transfer function is not applicable if the system is not linear and time invariant. Also, if initial conditions are not zero. So, I will consider a mechanical system, simple mechanical system as shown in this figure. Mass m is subjected to a force f of t. The displacement of mass m is x of t. This is figure 1. The corresponding mechanical network is shown in figure 2. We have independent node x of t, reference node O. Spring K is between x of t and ground. Damper B is between x of t and ground. Mass F is connected between x of t and ground. Force F of t is applied to node x of t. This is figure number 2, which represents mechanical network. Let us consider a mechanical system. As shown in figure 1. The corresponding mechanical network is as shown in figure 2. The equation of motion for mass m is written by writing the nodal equation at this node. The equation of motion for mass m is m into d square x by dt square plus b into dx by dt plus k into x is equal to f of t. If you write a small letter for x, it is understood it's a function of time. This is a linear differential equation. Therefore, this differential equation represents a linear system. The coefficients of various derivatives are constants. Therefore, the system under consideration is time invariant. Taking Laplace transform taking Laplace transform on both sides, taking Laplace transforms on both sides with all initial conditions, with all initial conditions equal to zero gives m into s square into x of s plus b into s into x of s plus k into x of s is equal to f of s. This implies x of s divided by f of s represented as g of s is equal to 1 over ms square plus bs plus k. X of s is Laplace transform. X of s is Laplace transform the output x of t. F of s is Laplace transform of the input f of t. Hence the ratio x of s by f of s is called transfer function and is denoted by g of s. G of s in equation 1 is defined as the transfer function of the system depicted in figure 1. Equation 1 may be represented by a block diagram as shown in figure number 3. Inside the block, we write the transfer function. This is the input, which is f of s. Output is x of s. You cross multiply. What is x of s? F of s into g of s. Input into transfer function equals output. So, the transfer function transfers the input to the output side. Okay, this is called block diagram representation. This is called block diagram representation. Next few important points I'll tell about the transfer function. Important points. First one, the inverse Laplace transform of g of s, namely g of t, is called impulse response of the system. Is called impulse response of the system. Note that g of t is impulse response, g of s is transfer function. Laplace transform of g of t is transfer function g of s. Inverse Laplace transform of g of s is the impulse response g of t. Therefore, g of t and g of s form Laplace transform pair. It may be noted that g of t and g of s form the Laplace transform pair. Laplace transform pair. The numerator polynomial of g of s equal to 0 will give zeros of the transfer function. Denominator polynomial equal to 0 will give you the poles of the system. I will write the numerator polynomial of g of s equal to 0 will give system zeros. Why? The denominator polynomial polynomial of g of s equated to zero will give system poles. These are the two important points regarding g of s, the transfer function. Next, I am going to teach you block diagram reduction techniques. A system will have blocks for each of the subsystem interconnected in some manner. All those subsystems must be reduced into an equivalent system. That requires a technique called block diagram reduction technique. I am going to explain that now. There are certain rules. One by one, I shall explain. Block diagram reduction techniques. First one, combining blocks in cascade. We have two blocks G1 and G2 in cascade. The input to G1 is X1. Output of G1 is X1. Output of G2 is X2. Output of G2 is X3. So what is X3? What is X2? X2 is nothing but G1 into X1. What is X3? X3 is G2 multiplied by X2. So this is nothing but G1, G2, X1. Because X2 is equal to G1 into X1. So this is the original block diagram. This is the original block diagram. BD is the abbreviation for block diagram. This is replaced by an equivalent block diagram. Equivalent block is what? G1, G2. Input is X1, output is X3. What is X3? X3 is X1 multiplied by G1, G2. So X3 in this case and in this case remains same. Therefore, this is equivalent block diagram. So if you have two blocks in cascade, you shall multiply the transfer functions to get the equivalent transfer function. Second one, combining blocks in parallel. compiling blocks in parallel. This is the original block diagram. This is the original block diagram. We have got two blocks, G1 and G2, in parallel. Both these blocks receive the same input, which is X1. What is X2? Input into transfer function. Therefore, it is G1 into X1. What is X3? G2 into X1. What is X4? X4 is X2 plus minus X3. The polarity is plus minus. So in the reality, real problem it could be either plus or minus. So what is X4, X2 plus minus X3? What is X2? X2 is G1, X1. What is X3? G2, X1. So equivalent block I am going to write now. This is nothing but G1 plus minus G2 multiplied by X1. The equivalent block I am going to write, this is X1. Inside the block, I will write G1 plus minus G2. Output X4. What is X4 in this figure? X4 is G1 plus minus G2 multiplied by X1. X4 in this figure are same. Therefore, this is the equivalent block diagram. This is the equivalent block diagram. So, if there are two blocks in parallel, the equivalent transfer function is obtained by adding the respective transfer functions with proper polarities. This is combining blocks in parallel. Next, we'll move to this is the symbol for a summer. Third one, moving a summing point. Moving a summing point behind a block. Moving a summing point behind a block. The next rule is a summing point that receives the inputs x1 and x2. Let us assume both the polarities are plus. What is the output of the summer? X1 plus X2. Let it be multiplied by G. What is the output? G multiplied by X1 plus X2, which is nothing but G into X1 plus G into X2. What is front of a block and what is back of a block, you must understand. See here. Let me take a block like this. Inside the block, I have written the transfer function G. This is the input, this is the output. Along the direction of the flow, this end you reach first. Therefore, this is the front of a block. This is behind, this is back of a block. Don't get confused. In the direction of the arrow, correct, this end is reached first. Therefore, this is the front of a block. This is part behind of a block. Now, moving a summing point behind a block means, this is original block diagram, means what? Moving a summing point behind a block. Behind a block means to this location. So please see what happens. So this summing point I have moved here. So what is the output of this block? It is G1 into X1. So what should be my output? My output should be G into X1 plus G into X2. Therefore, this signal must be G into X2. That means x2 has to be multiplied by g. Then always remember the output of this block should be g into x1 plus g into x2, whatever manipulation you do. You look at this figure, what is the output of, what is the output? G into x1 plus g into x2. So what is important is, if you move this summing point over here, x1 must be multiplied by g, x2 also should be multiplied by g. This is rule number 3, moving a summing point behind a block. I hope it is clear. Next is, moving a summing point, ahead of a block, First let me write the original block diagram. This is the original block diagram. This figure is actually equivalent block diagram. Now what is the text? Moving a summing point ahead of the block. So what is the output of this block? Output of this block is g into x1. So what is the output of the summer? Output of the summer is g into x1 plus x2. Now this summing point has to be moved here. If you move the summing point over here, what is the modification that we have to do is the question. This is the summing point. Input is x1. Okay. This is x2. What should be the output? Output of this summer should be g into x1 plus x2. So let us assume that means whatever manipulation you do, correct now, you have to get this output. So x1 has to be multiplied by g. What is this? What should be the signal here? The signal here should be, what? Signal here should be x1 plus 1 by g into x2. x1, if you multiply this input signal by g, what you get? x1 into g. 1 by g into x2 means 1 by g into g gets cancelled out. So here you will get g into x1 plus x2. Same output as in this case. That means x2 has to be multiplied by 1 by g. x2 has to be multiplied by 1 by g. Very important. Moving a summing point ahead of a block means this summing point is moved over here, what is depicted in this figure. So we have to get the output as g into x1 plus x2 in the equivalent block diagram also. Hence, x2 has to be multiplied by 1 by g. So what is the outcome, what is the output of this summer? x1 plus 1 by g into x2. That when multiplied by g, gives g into x1 plus x2. Both the blocks have the same output in the form of g into x1 plus x2. Therefore, they are equivalent. This is equivalent block diagram. Next one, moving a takeoff point behind a block. So this is the original block diagram. This is the original block diagram. This is the takeoff point. Point from where a signal is taken. This is called takeoff point. Takeoff point or pickup point. Pickup point. Moving a takeoff point behind a block. That means this takeoff point should be moved over here. What is the modification we have to do? This is original block diagram. I am going to write now equivalent block diagram. Input is x1. Output has to be g into x1. Now this point is moved over here. So what we are getting? We are getting g into x1. What we have to get? X1. Therefore g into x1 must be multiplied by 1 by g to get back x of y. This is equivalent block diagram. Moving a takeoff point behind a block. So now this is the original block diagram. Moving a takeoff point behind a block. This is the behind, this is the front. So this takeoff point should be moved over here. When you move the takeoff point over here, what signal you are taking? G into x1. But what you have to get? X1. So g into x1 has to be multiplied by 1 by g to get back x1. Next rule. Moving a takeoff point. Moving a takeoff point ahead of a block. Ahead of a block. Ahead of a block. This is the original block diagram. This is the takeoff point. What we are taking? G into x1. Ahead of a block means this takeoff point should be moved over here. This is the original block diagram. X1, output is g into x1. When this takeoff point is moved over here, what you are taking? You are taking x1. What you have to get? G into x1. That means x1 should be multiplied by g to give you g into x1. This is equivalent block diagram. Simply remember in this manner. If you move takeoff point behind a block, you divide by 1 by g. If you move takeoff point ahead of a block, you multiply a pickup signal or takeoff signal by g. This you remember. And this, all these things we use while solving problems. Seventh rule. A summing point. A summing point with three inputs. A summing point with three inputs. Let me take a summing point having three inputs in the form of x1, x2 and x3. All the polarities are plus. The output of this summer is x1 plus x2 plus x3. This is original block diagram. Equivalent block diagram will write here. At a time, add two signals. First, add x1 and x2. What is the output of this summer? It is x1 plus x2. To x1 plus x2, you add x3. So, what is the output of this summer? X1 plus x2 plus x3. A summer with three inputs is equivalent to two summers with two inputs each. Last rule, eliminating a feedback loop eliminating a feedback loop. Let us consider a negative feedback system. Let us consider a negative feedback system as shown here. This is X2. Feedback signal is X2 multiplied by H. This is called actuating signal. This is called actuating signal. What is the actuating signal? X1 minus X2 into H. If X2 increases, X1 minus X2 into H decreases, so that X2 goes back to its normal value. That means there is corrective action. Instead of minus sign, if you put your plus sign, it becomes a positive feedback system. This is a negative feedback system. The actuating signal is X1 minus feedback signal. If output increases, actuating signal decreases. And conversely speaking, if output decreases, actuating signal increases. Hence, output is maintained constant. This is the configuration of a negative feedback loop. This is original. This is original block diagram. What is X2? X2 is equal to input into transfer function. That means X1 minus X2 into H multiplied by G. This implies X2 is equal to X1 into G minus X2 into G into H. So, you take this term to other side and take X2 common, X2 into 1 plus GH is equal to X1 into G. This implies X2 divided by X1 is equal to G divided by 1 plus GH. So, the original block diagram gets converted into an equivalent block diagram as depicted here. Inside the block, I write G by 1 plus GH. Input is X1, output is X2. This is equivalent block diagram. Equivalent block diagram. If you see the equivalent block diagram, the feedback loop is eliminated. The feedback loop is eliminated. So what is important here is, if you have minus sign, it is negative feedback. If you have plus sign, it is positive feedback. So this is a negative feedback system. Next we'll consider a positive feedback system. What happens we shall see now. This is a positive, if you make here plus, it becomes positive feedback system. I'll write here positive feedback system. So actuating signal will become what? X1 plus X2 into H. If output increases, actuating signal increases. This actuating signal is also called actuating signal increases. Correct? So if output increases, actuating signal increases. If actuating signal increases, output increases. They are in competition. Therefore, system will get destroyed. For this positive feedback system, what is the output? X2 is equal to X1 plus X2 into H multiplied by G. So this becomes plus, this becomes minus, this becomes minus. So the equivalent transfer function is G divided by 1 minus GH. Therefore, for a positive feedback system, the eliminating feedback loop gives equivalent transfer function G divided by 1 minus GH. For a negative feedback system, eliminating the feedback loop gives equivalent transfer function G divided by 1 plus GH. We shall now do problems on block diagram reduction algebra. So before doing problems, you must go through all the techniques that are given and keep that in memory. The first problem is reduce the block diagram shown below and find the transfer function C of S by R of S. Whenever a problem is given to you, you must keep in mind whether you have got two blocks in cascade, whether you have got two blocks in parallel, whether you have got a feedback loop. These things have to be identified. So in this case, we have got two blocks in cascade, so we will multiply them. So I will put a dotted box here, which means that there is some reduction applied inside that box. So first step is multiply G2 and G3. So what you get? You get this block diagram. This is step number 1. G2, G3, two blocks in cascade. Therefore, you multiply the respective transfer functions. Whenever you write a summer, give importance to the polarities. Now we have got two blocks in parallel. If you have got two blocks, G1 and G2 in parallel, you add those two blocks with proper polarities. This could be like G1, this could be like G1, this could be like G2. So G1 minus G2 because we have got a minus sign here. I will put a dotted box here, which means to the reader that we apply some reduction formula to reduce these two blocks in parallel. That is step number 2. G2, G3, minus G4. Minus sign because the polarity at this summer is minus. At this point it is minus. Whenever you apply reduction formula for two blocks in parallel, the summing point will get eliminated. So as you progress through the problem, the number of summers should keep reducing. I want to reiterate, if you have two blocks in parallel, for example, assume this as GA. GA is what? G2, G3. GB is G4. So when you apply the formula for two blocks in parallel, it is GA minus GB, minus because it's minus here. What is GA? G2, G3. What is GB? G4. Again, I made it very clear. Now we have got three blocks in cascade to multiply the respective transfer function. That is step number 3. G1, G5, G2, G3, minus G4. This is C of S. C means C of S. The transfer function here is 1 in the feedback path. Because C of S multiplied by 1 is C of S. Whenever you write a summer, please pay attention to the polarities. Up now, this feedback loop has to be eliminated. This is like G, this is like H. Negative feedback system. What reduction formula? G divided by 1 plus GH. So C of S divided by R of S is equal to G divided by 1 plus GH. What is G? G is G1, G5 multiplied by G2, G3 minus G4. What is H? 1. So I will write G1, G5 into G2, G3 minus G4 divided by 1 plus G1, G5, G2, G3 minus G4 into 1. This is the answer. Thank you. We shall go to next problem. Reduce the block diagram shown below and find C of S by R of S. This is the problem. We have to combine these two summing points. By combining these two summing points, what I do is, I will take the signal as x1, I will take the signal as x2. So what is the output of this summer? It is x1 plus x2. What is the output here? It is R of S I will write as R minus x1 plus x2, which is R minus x1 minus x2. So we will combine these two summers into one summer. That is step number one. So this is R. So what is this? This is nothing but this block is G3. Output of G3 is what? Output of G3 is X1 minus, because you have got minus X1 here. Then this, instead of writing this X2, is this X2 is nothing but C of S only. Please note that this X2 is nothing but C of S only. This is minus, this is x2 is nothing but C of S. So what is the signal here? It is again R minus x1 minus x2, same as the input. In this case, input to G1 is R minus x1 minus x2. Here also input to G1 is R minus x1 minus x2. So two summing points having two inputs each, I have combined into one summing point having three inputs, which are the three inputs R, x2 and x1. Now I split this summing point again into two summing points. Take off points, you put a bullet like this. See now, what is the signal over here? It is R minus X2. What is the signal over here? It is R minus X2 minus X1. In all these manipulations, the input to G1 is R minus X1 minus X2. So I made a small mistake, I have to include G2. Okay. So I made a small mistake which I have corrected. Now we have got a feedback loop here which will eliminate using the formula G divided by 1 plus GH. It is a negative feedback loop, therefore G by 1 plus GH. What is G? G is G1. What is H? G3. So the reduction becomes step number 3. G is G1, H is G3. The 1 plus G1, G3. This is G2. Output is C of S. We have two blocks in step number 4. We have two blocks in cascade. We multiply the respective transfer functions. That will lead to this block diagram. Again, we have got a negative feedback system. G is G1, G2 by 1 plus G1, G3, and what is H? H is 1. So, C of S divided by R of S is equal to G divided by 1 plus GH. G is what? G is G1, G2 divided by 1 plus G1, G3 by 1 plus G1, G2 divided by 1 plus G1, G3 into 1. You take LCM and simplify, that gives you the result G1, G2 divided by 1 plus G1, G3 plus G1, G2. This is the answer. These are all very simple problems. Complicated ones we will do in the next class. Thank you. There are more than one way to do a problem. Instead of combining these two summing points, what you can do is move this takeoff point over here. Correct? If you take this takeoff point over here, what you have to do is, correct now? This G3 has to be modified. After modifying G3, you will have two blocks, two paths in parallel. Add them, the summing point will go away. Like that also, you can try it out. Correct? What I want to say is, there is no one way of doing it. It's up to the intelligence of the student how he is going to solve. Thank you.